Okay, so the longer that all of this health crisis stuff goes on, I think the more and more likely it is that there's actually going to be yet another round of stimulus checks. Pretty much everyone's freaking out because there's nothing else to do. I mean, the longer that this goes on, everyone's kind of turning to the government to look for aid because there's no other option. So yesterday afternoon, there's a press release by a website called The Hill, which talks about yet another stimulus package that is in the works. Again, nothing's official, nothing's for sure yet, but the reason that they're doing this is to try to limit the damage that happens to the economy, because the longer that this goes on, the more detrimental it's going to be to the economy overall. Okay, so most people, they can usually float not having a paycheck for 1 or 2 weeks. But the majority of America lives paycheck to paycheck. So that meaning after about a month or so, people start to hurt a little bit without any source of income. And again, most people don't even have an emergency fund. I know it's recommended to have at least 3 to 6 months in an emergency fund. This is exactly what they're talking about. That's why you need to have that set in place for emergencies just like this. So, needless to say, a lot of people are in a bind. But let's say this goes on for 3 months or so, or 6 months, or even a year. Let's say after 6 months, everything just magically resolves, everybody's healthy, there's no issues anymore. It's not that easy just to pick back up where we left off. So let's think about a restaurant, for example. Let's say it's not a franchise restaurant, it's not McDonald's or anything like that. It's just kind of a mom and pop shop, cafe, diner, whatever you have it. So most of restaurants like this, they don't have more than a month's cash in reserves, maybe 2 months. So if this goes on for 3 months or 6 months, and they're dependent on customers coming in for revenue to be able to float their business, they don't have customers in coming to eat because they can't. Everyone's worried about getting sick and all this kind of stuff. And so likely that business is going to go under. Now, when everything recovers, the waitresses and the waiters that used to work there previously, there's nothing for them to return to because there's no restaurant any longer. This went on too long. So again, this goes without saying, but the longer that this goes on, the more detrimental effects are going to happen to the economy, and it's not that easy to just pick back up and start where we left off. So it's reasons like this that we need another stimulus package. And I've talked about this in other videos. I've talked about hyperinflation. I'm not going to touch on that again, but there can't be any good things that come from just injecting all of this money into the economy, but it's also not good to have people out of work with the spikes in unemployment and all that kind of stuff. So pretty much whether we do a stimulus, we get burned, or whether we don't do a stimulus, we get burned. And so it kind of makes sense to do the stimulus in the sense that it helps people out, even with the negative effects that it's going to have to the economy long term. I expect that it is very likely there will be a phase 4 deal, and we're going to be speaking with the president throughout the week about what he thinks should be in there, said Hassett. And Hassett he's a financial economic advisor to the president at the White House. In just the last 5 weeks alone, there have been more than 25 million people who have filed for unemployment. And you guys have seen that graph. I mean, unemployment looks like this, and then it shoots up like exponentially. And those numbers are continuing to climb. 5 weeks, 25 million people have filed for unemployment. So that guy Hassett that mentioned that quote earlier, I was looking at another one of his articles, and he said that during the Great Depression, we lost 8.7 million jobs due to the whole thing. He said, we're now losing that many every 10 days. Every 10 days, we're losing the same amount of jobs compared to the entire Great Recession as a whole. So he continues on to say, he says, I think the odds of there not being another round, at least another round of legislation, are pretty low. So everyone's kind of heard of that $2,000 per month stimulus package, right? I think when everybody first announced that and it was kind of all the rage and everyone was talking about it, people kind of scoffed at it. Like, there's no way that's gonna happen. There's no way possible that everyone's going to be able to get that much money. There's no way that that amount is going to be approved by Congress. It's too much. And how is that gonna happen? What are the effects on the economy? I'm not so sure anymore. I was on that train as well. I did not think that that was going to pass, but I think things are starting to change just a little bit. Okay, so that's all the information that I have for now, but I do know that Congress is meeting again in just a couple more days. And so I'm sure that when that happens, there's going to be a ton of new information that's released when that happens. Thanks for sticking around. I'm trying to keep you guys updated and current with all the issues that are coming out in the news and all the stimulus packages and the bills and legislation, everything that's happening. So again, trying to keep you updated. Please check back here in a little bit for more updated information. Until then, thanks for watching. I'll catch you next week.